Thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to be discussing the Pilates exercise swimming. Now, swimming is a really great opportunity to open up your shoulders and also get some spinal extension as well as work muscles like the glutes and the hamstrings. We're going to start off in small increments though, because swimming in and of itself, just regularly, is a relatively challenging posture for some people, and so we're going to break it down. First, let's start with the upper body. To get your shoulders used to moving correctly and to get that extension, you can practice sitting up nice and tall, and the arms reach up, and you're going to flutter back and forth. Now, you want to make sure we're not like doing this from the elbow. When I do this from the elbow, my shoulders don't move at all. Okay, guys? So we've got the arms reaching and they're moving from the shoulders. Forward and back, forward and back, forward and back. Now, when you do this normally, you'll use the same breathing that you would for the 100. So it's inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 3, 4, 5. Okay? That's one version of swimming you can do. You can also be on your hands and knees. And this exercise is a lot like the yoga pose sunbird. Knees are under the hips, hands are under the shoulders, low belly lifts, a leg reaches out, and it lifts up, hugs toward the midline. The opposite arm reaches out, and it lifts, shoulder height. We lower down, and we switch. Belly button to the spine, reach the leg out, and lift. Arm reaches out, and it lifts too. Okay, so that's another option. If you're wanting to just work your legs, you come onto your stomach. I like to do hands stacked one on top of the other. You can have your legs in parallel, or you can have them turned out. I'm going to do parallel. So my legs are parallel, they're hip width apart, my feet are pointed. I'm going to stack my hands, belly button to the spine to lift the legs, and now I'm just going to flutter kick. Same thing as the arms, we're going to use that breathing for the 100. So it's inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Now, when you want to take it to the next level, you will reach your arms out, reach your legs out, you'll be on your stomach. Again, we're going to do that same breathing for the 100. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. To lift up, you want to get a good spinal extension without compromising the safety of your low back, okay? So your number one step, draw your belly button up to the spine. Support that low back. Then lift into extension, okay? So come onto your stomach. Legs hip width apart, arms shoulder width or wider. If your shoulders are tight like mine are, you might want to give it some extra space to make sure you can do it correctly. Nice long line, reaching from the top of the head out through the toes. Inhale, the abdominals up to the spine, and we lift, and here we go. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale, and lower down. Obviously, if you're doing the full exercise, you want to go for longer than that. I recommend 10 sets, okay? Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. That makes one set. You do 10 of those, so it's just like you're breathing for the 100, okay? And the whole time, you're fluttering the arms and the legs. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, you can find me over at my website, www.custompilatesandyoga.com. Thank you.